Okay, gang, you've been waiting all night for him. Here he is. There's no way to introduce him other than to say he's the two funniest four-letter words in the whole world. Mr. Red Fox!
Thank you very much if you applauded for me. If you didn't applaud, I hope your dog dies. I'm only serious. See, you know, I'm a little hoarse. It says four women to every man in New York. And last night, two guys didn't have nobody. I was only just said that, you know, give you an idea of what's coming. I talk about sex mostly because a lot of our parents had it. How are you? Took a chance and came on uptown, huh? I bet you won't be around here by 7:30. And neither will I. No, I don't. No, it's serious. The economy is bad. I mean, I don't mind how things have happened. A nigga tried to rob me night before last. That's right. Nigga gonna stick up a black man. Now, wasn't that dumb? Nigga gonna rob Zorro. This nigga jumped out the alley. Didn't have a gun, a pipe, or a brick. All he knew was karate. Jumped out there and said, stick up. I got a black belt. I said, well, they gonna need it to lower your ass in the ground. See, I always leave my zipper down for my first joke. See, and if you don't laugh, then everything's cool. She's so pretty. How much you weigh, honey, 100? I had more than that for lunch. Some pretty girls in New York, and some ugly ones. I'm not gonna point you out, you know who you are. Sitting up there trying to look better now. You're some ugly kids here in New York. Why? Because they have ugly parents here in New York. The ugly kids come from ugly parents. If you think I'm lying, follow an ugly kid home and see don't somebody ugly open the door for him. I know, I used to go home. What the hell are you laughing at? You ain't no dream either. Sitting out there looking like somebody shit in your face. That's why I said shit. I said shit not to shock anyone. I said shit because I'm too old to stand up here and say doo-doo. If you would tell the truth, everyone here said shit. You've never said shit before. Come on out the parking lot with me and let me slam my car door on your hand. You'll say shit and motherfucker. Shit, motherfucker! That's a normal reaction uptown. You think they gonna say darn downtown? Oh, darn. I say shit. I got a St. Bernard dog, weighs 260 pounds. He does not doo-doo. You cannot give a dog 10 cans of Alpo and expect him to doo-doo. St. Bernard, shit. And I got a yard full to prove it. My neighbor called the police, had a bunch of shit in my yard. It's not a narco squad. He said, all right, Fox, where's all that shit? I say, in the backyard, they go roll you some. It's not bad. All women have said shit when you fellas came home with that lie. You remember? The subway broke down. We were caught down there 5 hours. And that's buttermilk on my shorts. The old lady said, you expect me to believe that shit? Men have said shit. Fellas, remember the first meal your new bride sat before you? And you said, what's this shit? That's marriage. Marriage is a bunch of shit. I shouldn't say that because you might think I'm angry about getting divorced. after 18 years of marriage. I know you want to know about my private life. It's none of your goddamn business. But I'll tell you anyway. The reason why I'm getting divorced is because my wife had to be going crazy. And I was afraid to be there with her. No, I really thought she was going crazy. She thought I was Jesus. I was laying there one night, just come out the shower. She turned to me and said, Fox, can you rise? I said, yeah, if you can hold on till Easter. Yeah, that's a good laugh back there. Damn, Eric. None of your goddamn business. What I got in the cup didn't cost you nothing. Remember, that's where Lincoln got it. Huh? Got another one? Why don't you just relax, brother? This is not your act. If you got an act, find you a job. Stick with what you know, nigga, labor. I don't fool around with labor. I can sit down and watch labor all month. Just smile right out. You ain't laughed to nothing, honey. Your hair hurt? Who does your hair, Phyllis Diller? This bald head cat laughing. What the hell you laughing at? I see more hair on a peanut butter sandwich. We find another guy with a head like his, and they lean in close, it would look like somebody's ass. Oh, ass head. The head you roll your eyes at for young blood. And close your legs. Step your leg like one of my old women at the bus stop. She don't know if I don't see them old snuggies. See, you'd be surprised how time can change the meaning of a word. Now, most of you now, you know, the funky chicken and the dancing, the funky, and the thing is called the funky melon, you know, all that kind of funky black-eyed pea. When I was a kid, funky didn't have nothing to do with music. See, funky was just plain funky. See, funky was grandma's bloomers. And grandpa's long drawers with the nicotine stain in the back. Where he had sneezed and got snuff in him. That was funky. I remember one time I was about 7 years old and we were playing hide and go seek. And I went in this lady's closet. We was playing hide and go seek in her house. I went in the closet where she kept her dirty clothes. Funky. God damn, it was funky, man. It was so funky in her closet, I gave up. I said, here I am, come get me. A lot of people don't know that. A lot of guys sitting here tonight with long toenails with dirt on them. Huh? You say, what? Speak right up, brother, I can't see you. I hate to wish something on somebody. I'll be getting lockjaw in the motel. That'll mess up your sex affair. How you, girl? A lot of girls out here by themselves. Hey, how many girls here alone? That's one and two sissies. Bullet. If your brother, y'all married? Don't lie now. Let me see your ring, honey. That nigga's cheap, goddamn. Man, you gave her that. Did he give you the Cracker Jacks too? I'm gonna move from over here. That's another reason my wife and I had a little trouble. She always begging for stuff. Last time we talked, she said, Fox, when am I gonna get a ring? I said, as soon as I step out this tub. Thank you, buddy. That's the way to laugh. Some people try to sit and look all stiff, like they know Oral Roberts personally. So, oh my God, oh my heavens. Philip, did you hear him say shit? Get the same broad to the hotel. No, she said, shit, Philip, don't move it, goddammit. Ah, you. Jesus knows your crooked Christian ass and what you've been doing. You ain't hiding nowhere. Jesus sees you going to hotels, motels, and rendezvous, and Shangri-Las, and rooming houses, laying up there buck-necking in sin. Jesus sees you in there. He recognizes the back of your head. And he knows you're not bobbing for apples. Look at him. Y'all together? No. You are. Puerto Rican? I didn't know. I didn't see no flies. Finny poking Puerto Ricans here. Don't be offended. Just think back when you're telling them nigger stories and relax. I talk about everybody. I was a Christian once, Catholic, altar boy, St. Benedict the More Mission, spoke Latin phonetically. Genius. Oh, really? Did it, baby? Confidio de me, you better miss it. I was surrounded by ghosts. Yeah, I found out I couldn't be Pope. I said, fuck him. I'm not going to sit in the back of heaven. I'm like Reverend Knight, give me my shit on the ground. Heaven, shh. It's so pretty. Black too, I love black women. You see me with the white woman, I'm holding her for the police. Of course, I'm no idiot. I prefer Raquel Welch over Shirley Chisholm. I prefer Joe Namath over Shirley Chisholm. But she still will never be the champion. Mrs. Roosevelt will always be number one. Champion. Mrs. Roosevelt, God damn. That's an ugly white woman. Damn, that was ugly, man. I saw Mrs. Roosevelt's picture in Jet magazine and got a soft on. Tell her, darling, so explain it to her. Soft on. This dude over here with the ball, he's trying to act like he ain't never had none. Yeah, my old lady wanna make love all the time. Wanna make love all the goddamn time. Sometime twice a month. I had to trick her. She wanted to make love. I had to fool her one night. I got her drunk. I got drunk getting her drunk. She showered and laid down and spread eagle, and I moved into my position. She says, "It in?" I said, "I'm through." Out loud, honey, to hell with them people. You don't have to worry about nobody but yourself. I don't have no heart attack holding that wind in it. Laugh. Get drunk tonight and throw up in a cab. What's wrong with America? We've forgotten how to puke. God damn. The jaws on that hippopotamus. My old lady got one. I mean, my ex old lady had one of them. Damn. Shit. Hey, go ahead and laugh, goddamn. I hope you're a perpetual soft on. Let's drink a toast to some other humans around the world and what they laugh at. If you don't have anything, I'll handle it for you.
You what?
You're not too coherent. Where are you from? Now you sitting up here and I can't even understand you. Say it again, Ripple? Ripple. I don't drink wine, brother. I used to, ain't no need to be lying. I used to drink it. I found Chevy's. Now I don't throw up on myself and have a hangover. If I do throw up on myself, I know how much it costs. And rest your lips anyway, because you got a busy night ahead of you. This is your night in the barrel. I didn't know you knew the barrel story, honey. You're premature gray one there. She's pretty. I bet you were beautiful now, 1941. Because you look good now. I want to meet me abroad with some property. I'm tired of a bunch of poor broads asking me for something. Shit. Chick asked me for $100 in Las Vegas like it was a cheese sandwich. She forced me to say shit. Yeah, I said, what you doing later on? She said, $100. I said, shit. $100. I wish I had something on me cost me $100. I'd cut it off and barbecue it. $100. I don't want to live with no broad. I just want to drop in for a few minutes. And some of them $100 broads, you can drop right in. Humor. Confucius say, crowded elevator smell different to midget. Mexican humor. Why does it have hair around it? To keep it from looking like a taco. Guess you've never seen a taco. See, they cut like this. No, they cut like this. And then you hold it like this so the meat won't fall out. Have you ever eaten one? You nigga, I asked you a question. You didn't get mad, did you, brother? You know, both of us got knives, so it's a draw. I swear I got a knife. I was born in St. Louis, Missouri. Used to wake up buck naked and put my knife on. But that's a lie they tell up on black people. Say, all black people carry knives. I'm gonna tell the truth. That's a lie, because in truth, I've been carrying ice pick 32 years. Shucks, I don't like violence. That's why I don't join no groups, and I'm gonna keep eating pork. I'm gonna keep eating beef and bananas, whatever I like to eat, don't interfere with it. Eat what you love, don't mess with other folks. A hog ain't no uglier than a cow. You look at a cow sometime with that big snotty nose and them dirty tits. There's one thing I can't stand is a snotty nose. I'll clean up a dirty tit. Hey, honey, you dressed for church. Did you go to church? Here she comes. You took all eyes off my show. You by yourself? Watch this. If you're ready for a strange piece, smile. She's laughing out loud. I don't want none of that. No, I hate when them old broads keep talking while you're trying to make love. It's good. Oh, tell me it's good. Oh, goddamn it, kill it. It's yours. Oh, I know. Daddy. I said, shit, I just met you. Oh, daddy, don't know. It's good. Is it good? I said, wait a minute. You want to talk or fuck? I mean, is it good? Goddamn right, it's good. It's better than okra. All I need is a hum every now and then. Mm. That's plenty. Then you can hold your custard longer. Say, listen, brother, got a gold tooth in your mouth? Don't you go outside tonight and smile with that gold tooth. One of them niggas will dig a mine in your mouth. Hey, let me stop fooling around and start my act. No, really, this was just warm up.
Jesus Christ.
Husband overseas? Really? Shame on him. I was overseas 4 years, came back home, my old lady was pregnant. She met me down at the doctor, said, Fox, you're a father. Huh? I said, and you a mother. Hey, you wanna sing something? What's your favorite piece, dear, you remember? You don't remember, huh? Been so many good pieces, hasn't it? That's why you live uptown now. We're gonna sing Row, Row, Row Your Boat Gently Down the Stream, merrily, merrily, merrily. It's like a dream, all of you remember. I'll show you how strangers can sing in perfect harmony. Just don't try to solo. Let's blend on the downbeat. Row, row, row your boat gently down. Well, all the human beings in the room sing on the downbeat. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, merrily. All the good-looking people. A few liars dropped in there. Amen. Once more, everyone. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream, merrily, 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 merrily. Just the girls this time. Men, row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Sing it, goddammit, come on! Life is but a dream. Now you others. Come on, I know if a crowd this side got to be one fag in here. Where you at, honey? Bend over, I'll drive you to Newark. Hey, listen, this guy went to the doctor. He said, Doc, look at here. He said, look, Doc. Doc said, how'd you get that? He said, I stick it in beans. Doc said, what kind of beans? He said, human beans. And another guy went to the doctor and said, Doc, look at here. And Doc looked, he said, oh. He said, Doc, I think I caught coal in it. Doc squeezed it. He said, well, let's call it clap till it coughs. That's it, Slim. I was laying in bed last night talking to my wife's sister. No, on the phone. Gee, what a dirty crowd is here now. I should have got to my main stuff. Listen, let me show you how you react. I'm gonna tell the story, and when I get to the punchline, everybody's gonna be quiet, and then you'll all start laughing together. Watch, pro, I know what I'm talking about. Two girls walk down the street, and one girl hunched up and said, hey girl, look across the street, isn't that your husband coming out the florist? She said, yes, damn it, he's got 2 dozen roses. She said, I'm gonna have to keep my legs up in the air 3 days. Her girlfriend said, well, why don't you get a vase? Could I help you with it? Oh, God. A toast. Let's drink a toast to someone decent. Let's think. We'll be here all night trying to think of something. Any war veterans here? None of y'all fought? I was a hero in World War II. Wounded in Newark, New Jersey. Shot coming out of the whole house with a soldier's wife. Hit me in the wallet. Right back in the wallet. Hadn't been for all them addresses, I'd have really been seriously hurt. I don't like no stuff going on behind me, because, you know, New York. A friend of mine won't go home until October. Been mugged 38 times. 38 times in the same building. You ever been mugged, brother? Or are you the mugger? No, it get rough sometimes. People don't know how bad it was in St. Louis when I was a kid during the Depression. I mean, we were poor. And when Christmas time came, if I hadn't been a boy, I wouldn't have had nothing to play with. If you ever get drunk and go home and sit on the toilet and throw up in the face bowl, I've been drunk on that. I sat in the face bowl and threw up in the toilet. I say, God damn, they got a tall toilet in here. I came back a half hour later, put some cold water on my forehead, and I reached in the face. I said, damn, I don't remember eating that. Ooh, I've had them on, Jim. I've been drunk in my day. How many people here are religious? I saw them holy clothes you wearing. Right here, buddy. These niggas ain't never been out before. Yeah, brother, go ahead. You by yourself? You know why? Have you tried band roll on? Sitting up there with them long toenails and them sneakers. Foot smell like somebody shit in it. Y'all don't be fooling around. I tell the truth. Nothing's secret. What am I smoking? Man, this is not a question and answer period. Nigga, why don't you go home and kill some gentry so you can sleep later on? Bugging me, why don't you go downtown and hurt a white act, nigga? Thank you, brother. He's all right, I'm just kidding. Put your spear back. No kidding, I don't need interruption. I'm so good alone. Leave me alone and watch. Put that where you want to, honey. I love black women, I'm not lying. When I pull my covers back, I want to see what's laying there on the white sheet. I had a white girl once blended right into the sheet. I missed her and bit a hole in the mattress. Don't look at me. Show me a husband who won't, and I'll show you a neighbor who will. Let me get my cigarette fresh. I smoke and drink. A lot of you don't drink, no smoke. Some people here tonight, they don't eat butter, no salt, no sugar, no lard, no biscuits, no gravy with onions in it. Because they want to live. They give up that good stuff. Neck bone, pigtail. You're going to feel like a damn fool laying out the hospital dying from nothing. I've been smoking 40 years. If I don't have cancer now, I probably have something that will eat it up. Cancer better not fuck with my body. I mean that. There's a lot of things worse than cancer. A 6'6" black nationalist in an alley with a hatchet mad at you is worse than cancer. No, brother. You know I wasn't smoking no gangsta out here. You know, you're kind of dumb. And ugly. Why don't you play horse with him? He'll be the head and you'll be what you were. I don't know why y'all keep jumping in the show. Act like you ain't never been out of a room before. Got to be living in a room because you don't act like homeowners. Why make me suffer with your cheap room and ass? I hate a loud broad screaming all across the theater. Embarrassing old man. I wish my old lady would embarrass me somewhere like that. I bet her lip get to the hospital before the ambulance. They be sewing up her lip when her ass arrived. Don't look at me, lady. Yes, I said lie, ass. That's what I said. And I said shit too. And later on in the show, I'm gonna say fuck. To me, fuck is not dirty unless you didn't wash up. Then you're fucking dirty. Guess what I said, lady? Fuck. What you think you and your husband been doing all these years? Hey, let me tell you one of my favorite stories. I think it's my favorite. A teacher was standing in a classroom. He said, kids, today I'd like you to give me a sentence using the word definitely. So a little girl stood up and said, teacher, the sky is definitely blue. She said, no, Marianne, when the storm clouds fill the sky, it's not definitely blue. She said, I'm another little girl. She said, teacher, the grass is definitely green. She said, no, Barbara, when the sun shines down hot on the grass, it browns it, so it's not definitely green. She said, our little boy stood up and said, look, teacher, can I ask you a question first? She said, of course, Billy, what is it? He said, well, teacher, when you break wind, does it have lumps in it? She said, no, Billy. He said, well, I have definitely shit. What, sir? Let's hear a song. Talk to him. He didn't want to hear no song. God damn. Should have been left on a picnic in a Kleenex. Or down your daddy's throat. At your mammy's. That don't hurt no nigga no more. It should, niggas shouldn't hurt nobody. Niggas in the dictionary makes sense. Niggas are lazy and shiftless. Don't get mad about that. Just mean we got some white niggas too. You don't believe in some white niggas? Watch Hee Haw. Yeah, I saw one show, one of them said, raining, baby brother. He said, I don't know. Why don't you call the dog in and see if he's wet? That's a lazy, shiftless nigga. A lot of whites think black people talk bad. They fail to stop and realize southern whites taught Africans English. African didn't know nothing about this here and and yonder and gone and get it and It's not African. Southern whites said, no, boy, goddammit, I tell you get that there. No, I tell you get that there yonder. Now chunk it over here, boy. Chunk it. Africans say, ooma gooma. Which means chunk that shit yourself. Kiss my black ass. Fuck you. homeless people here? Hey, nigga, pay more and get a good seat. Hey, let me stop fooling around and tell you a few stories. Okay, honey, thank you very much. That's your husband? Anywhere. Must be somebody in the world, won't you? I know I don't. How you feel, buddy? You don't smile too much. Were you a fighter? No? Just had that face from the beginning, huh? Nigga looked like he had been knocked out. How you feel, brother? Good, nice, pretty wife. We've been friends a long time, you know that? You didn't think nothing. I mean, she told me about you, love you too. Good contrast, some of this and some of that. It's pretty shirt too, good you dressing for traffic. That's right, I hate to see a black woman in basic black and pearls trying to keep up with white people. Basic black and pearl, you get your black ass run over out there in basic black and pearl. Truck driver get away free. So judge, I thought the pearls were floating in the air. Put some colors on, be proud, dress up, put that red, that's a good shirt, that's, huh? Nice dress, honey. Nice, Aren't you the girl who walked up the aisle last show? Good God Almighty. Talking about hind parts. Hey, a lady went in the market, and there was some chickens up on the counter, and she picked up one of them chickens and smelled his neck, and smelled around, and he was in, she called the butcher and said, come here, man. These chickens stink. Butchers looked at his hell. I doubt if you could pass a test like that. She said, well, just give me a Long Island duck. So the butcher gave her a duck, and she sniffed the duck. She said, man, this is a Michigan duck. He gave her another duck, she sniffed the duck. She said, man, this is a Wisconsin duck. He gave her another duck. She said, now, this is a Long Island duck butcher. She said, you must be new here, aren't you? He put on his pants and said, you tell me. Don't let people fool you. I haven't joined any group yet because it's hard to give up pork. You can't cold turkey pork just right away. Guy asked me, how can you eat pork? I said, knife and fork and hot sauce. Green, black-eyed peas, canned sweet potatoes, and peach cobbler, and a diet right cola. He said, you resemble what you eat. I said, well, no wonder you look like a pussy to me. The lady over here looked at her husband. Ain't nothing wrong with it. Most of you will be somewhere tonight indulging in sex. Think of me and smile. Don't laugh in it, just smile. Hey, you tell you don't know what I'm talking about. Let me say this to you and then I'm leaving because I gotta go to the toilet. This is what I came here for to tell you. If you're here today with someone you love, this is the right moment to listen carefully to what I tell you. You'll be together the rest of your life, never have no trouble no more. If someone had told you what I'm about to tell you earlier in your life, be considerate of your mate. Care, worry about their feelings. The most important thing you must do in a romance, a love affair, social contact, physical. When you love someone, you got to wash your ass. Don't look at me, lady, I'm telling the truth. You got to wash your ass. You can let your armpits go 2 days, but not your ass. How can you tell someone I love you, darling, knowing in your heart you haven't washed your ass? Now, dear friends and fellow Americans, I'm not talking about your whole ass. I'm talking about your asshole. You'd be surprised the pollution that can be found in an area the size of a dime, or a 50-cent piece, or a silver dollar. You know your ass better than I do. But you got to wash your ass. How can you turn around with your loved one and 64? What, darling? What'd you say? Oh, you're right. I'm sorry. She's right. 69. I'm sorry. Thank you so much. 69. I can never thank you enough. Thank you so much. How can you 69 with the lady's right? How can you 69 with your loved one and haven't washed your ass? Hell, it ain't but an inch away. And you lay there thinking, no one knows. Shit, the nose knows. Dearly beloved, when you go home tonight, for the first time in your life, for some of you, wash up. Come to bed damp for a change. Only Yule Gibbons will eat in dry bush country. And fellas, jump in that water and wash them wild hickory nuts. But don't get under the cover all funky and dry. And pull them covers up over you and turn and kiss goodnight and covers raise up and settle back down and blow that breeze up your nose. What happened, honey? Did your monkey die?
Mr. Red Fox.